From this revelation of August 28, 1994, where Jesus in a revelation to his maiden speaks of the three most beautiful feasts and Jesus says, "Warn all my daughter, warn all my children not to look elsewhere, not to hear the song of the sirens, not to be seduced by those who use my name. Give me the chance that day to thank you for your love, the love that you have been able to arouse for you and your brothers. Then, only then, will my heart rest. This will be the third most beautiful feast in paradise. The first was my ascent to heaven, the second, even more beautiful, was the assumption to heaven of my mother, and now heaven on earth, my return among you." Here are these words that have been heard so many times by those for many years are on this journey. Now they are more current than ever, and now we will put them back in the center one after the other so that understanding can be total. To make it clear that there is a single thread that links the beginning of this mystery with everything we are living. One is the plan of the Father that started then that is now being fulfilled in totality. Here then is that even heaven awaited this moment, first most beautiful feast. Then with surprise of many the second feast even more beautiful, that of the Assumption of Mary. Jesus says, that moment was even more beautiful for heaven. Surprising for many it could be, but not for us. We have already meditated on the mystery of Jesus the Redeemer and Mary co-redemptrix. Jesus saves. Mary united to the Son with the Son for the Son in the Son, save. Christ the Redeemer, Mary co-redemptrix, and then we are not surprised if Jesus says that that moment is an even more beautiful feast that must be lived and made understand. In 40 days Jesus rises to heaven, and what happened to Mary? This moment is not well known. I tell you by analogy, Mary has lived the same path. Here too this church lives and meditates the moment of Mary's ascent to heaven, of the Marian ascent. The 40 days preceding August 15th, the feast of the Assumption of Mary. Jesus dies and rises again on the third day, and after 40 days he ascends to heaven. And let us meditate on this journey also for Mary Mother of God, and so we arrive to the third most beautiful feast, my return among you, says Jesus in this revelation. Feast even more beautiful because this feast, that of the return, marks the moment of fulfillment. And then we must be prepared to live this moment of the return. We entered the month of the Feast of the Infant Jesus in June. On June 13th, we will celebrate this moment in a solemn way. On June 13th, the time of the Lord's return must be understood in order not to make the mistake that the Jewish people made when they did not welcome the Messiah who came into the world. The Jewish people waited for the Messiah to arrive great in power, in glory. Instead, the Father gave him to us, as happens for all children, in a simple and extraordinary way, in the same way, so God acts. Now the Christians await Jesus who returns on the clouds in great power. Be careful not to make the same mistake that was made by the Jewish people. The itinerary of the return of the Lord began with the descent of the infant Jesus on the 13th of June 1947, and from there began an itinerary that will lead us to total fulfillment.